In 1972, at Stockholm Conference, Srimati Indira Gandhi said that environment, we have not inherited it from our forefathers. We have borrowed it from our children. Environment, the world over is being destroyed by human beings today. We, the children, are witness to this destruction all around. It's our nimble fingers' responsibility to undo what the stronger hands has unleashed. When ably guided, we can change the world. In the process of our commitment to make this world a better place, we decided to join world's largest Design for Change School Challenge. We organized ourselves into a team. We wanted to make the whole school be a part of this challenge. We expressed our desire with our natural science teacher. She happily agreed to be our mentor. We have come up with multiple problems of our city in our discussions. Since September and October are the festive months, we unanimously decided to focus on the water pollution caused due to immersion of chemical colored Vinayaka idols. Basically, Vinayaka Chauthi is an eco-friendly festival. But as years passed, it became an eco-dangerous festival. In the history of Andhra Pradesh, Guntur has a place of pride educationally, culturally, etc. River Krishna drains Guntur district, making it agriculturally rich. It also serves the industrial and household purposes. The people of Guntur city and the surrounding areas immerse their chemical colored Ganesh idols in this river at Amaravati, which is 30 kilometers away from the city, polluting its waters. The same water is used for various purposes all along this river course. Due to this, river canals clog, storage capacity decreases, people become victims of waterborne diseases, the animals perish, soil gets polluted leading to low yield, aquaculture gets damaged. So, we wanted to promote our student families, their neighborhood, friends, relatives to use these mud idols, vegetable and organic colored clay idols of Ganesh made by our students on this Ganesh Chaturthi. At the outset, we, along with our teacher, met our principal, Reverend Sister Rosalyn, and explained our ideas. She was overwhelmed with our project and promised all the cooperation needed. She even called for the staff cabinet meeting. Thus, committees were formed with about 250 8th class students and two teachers for each committee to guide them.
Dedicate. Our friends eagerly prepared placards. Teachers helped us in preparing pamphlets. We approached traffic police department for the permission to go on an eco-friendly rally. We have informed the press and local TV channel about our project in order to bring more awareness among the people about eco-friendly Ganesh Utsav.
Our committee has requested Mr. Nagamalleswar Rao, the idol maker, to teach us how to make Ganesh idols with hands and molds. He readily accepted our wish and taught us idol making patiently. Our child artists made attractive Ganesh idols with their delicate hands. In a short span of 3 days, we could make 500 idols. On the last day, we sold a few idols at a very minimum price and distributed remaining idols free of cost to the children who could not afford.
As the preparation work progressed, some of our friends formed into a few teams and went to each class and explained to them about the water pollution caused by the immersion of chemical colored plaster of Paris Ganesh idols, its impacts on the plants, animals and human beings, and requested them to use mud idols, which are even less costly. Their message touched everyone's heart. The children promised our friends that they would explain to their parents, neighbors, relatives, friends, and make them buy only mud Ganesh idols. After the celebration, DEO Mrs. Parvati, Reverend Sister Roslyn, Reverend Sister Shaurilu, Reverend Sister Rani flagged off the rally. Our staff, our team, and about 250 8th class students took part in the rally with great enthusiasm. We started from our school and covered areas of busy roads near railway station, Guntur Government Hospital, NAS Center, market, and finally, fruitfully reached our school. On the way, we distributed pamphlets and urged people to use mud Ganesh idols only. We came across many good souls who understood our efforts. They patted us, encouraged us, appreciated us. Their response boosted our spirits. On the way, we visited two high schools and requested them to celebrate eco-friendly Ganesh Chaturthi. We all experienced a sense of achievement, fulfillment, and satisfaction that we too could contribute our mite, though it might be a drop in the ocean.
It is an exciting for me to motivate others through our campaign. I felt very happy while campaigning because due to my contribution towards eco-friendly rally, so many people might change their attitude and start using mud idols.
I was very much inspired by the whole program. I could successfully convince my neighbors, friends in buying the mud Ganesh idols. I am feeling very proud that I could change the people around me.
The whole DFC School Challenge project gave us a rich experience of togetherness. It taught us that through the teamwork, we can change the world. Yes, we are the world. We are the children. We are the ones who can brighten the world.